Hi, let's talk about the heart wall. In this video, we'll discuss the layers, superficial to deep, that one would encounter when cutting through the heart wall. We'll also talk about cardiac muscle tissue and how cardiac muscle cells differ from other types of muscle cells. So the heart wall has three major constituents: the epicardium, the myocardium, and the endocardium. And the heart itself is surrounded by both a pericardial cavity and portions of the pericardium. So the pericardium consists of the fibrous pericardium and then a serous pericardium. And that serous pericardium has a parietal component, which is fused to the fibrous pericardium, and then a visceral component, which is of the heart wall itself. And the space between the parietal and visceral layers of the serous pericardium is the pericardial cavity. Now, that visceral layer of the serous pericardium is mesothelial in nature. So it's simple squamous epithelium supported by a basement membrane. Now, this is riding atop a layer of fibroelastic connective tissue and adipose connective tissue. And that adipose connective tissue, which is beneath the epicardium, can be quite variable among individuals. And an overabundance of it can be correlated strongly with various cardiometabolic disorders. Now, also deep to the epicardium is the various neurovasculature which supports the heart, in particular, supports the myocardium. So the coronary arteries and their branches, the cardiac veins and their tributaries, etc. And these can most often be found within the sulci that are a part of the superficial features of the heart. Now, deep to the epicardium is the myocardium. And the myocardium is the most substantial layer of the heart wall. It's principally formed from cardiac muscle tissue, but it also has a healthy amount of fibroblast and other supportive connective tissue cells to help maintain the myocardium. The myocardium of the atria is distinctly different than that of the ventricles. There are physiological differences between the cardiomyocytes of the atria and the ventricles, but on a gross level, the atria tend to be much thinner, and the walls, the myocardia of the ventricles tend to be much thicker, especially on the left-hand side. The left ventricle serves systemic circulation. The right ventricle serves pulmonary circulation. So you can imagine the differences in pressure generation that the right has in order to reach the lungs versus the left ventricle has in order to reach all of systemic circulation. Now, deep to the myocardium is the endocardium, which is another layer of epithelium supported by a basement membrane. And you may imagine that the endocardium is not homogeneous throughout the heart, that it is quite different. The endocardium in certain areas will be very smooth. In other areas, the endocardium is going to take shape around the myocardium. So in the anterior portions of the atria, the endocardium will be more pectinate. Surrounding the ventricles, it will be more irregular. So we'll have the trabecula carnea. And another thing to keep in mind is that any of these layers of the heart, the epicardium, the myocardium, or the endocardium, can be the target of a disease or pathological process or even injury. So we can have pericarditis, epicarditis, myocarditis, or endocarditis. And while all of these etiologies can be very different and the prognoses may be very different among the different inflammations of these layers, they can all be part of some pathological process. Now, cardiac muscle tissue is very unique among all of the muscle tissues. It is the only muscle tissue to be branching. So an individual cardiomyocyte can bifurcate or trifurcate to touch several other cardiac myocytes. They are uninucleate, much like smooth muscles, much unlike skeletal muscle. And their mitochondria tend to be larger and more numerous than other types of muscle tissues. But probably the two greatest functions of cardiac myocytes are their intercalated discs and their propensity toward autorhythmicity. And these are related. So their intercalated discs are thickenings of their sarcolemma. And these are areas where two cardiomyocytes are coming together. And there are two novelties here that are of the utmost importance. One are the abundances of desmosomes, which are anchors to keep cardiac myocytes together. As you can imagine, the heart as an organ beats very early in development, and it beats until the time of death. And if a person is an organ donor, perhaps even beyond the time of death. And so to maintain the connections among the cardiomyocytes is very important. The second item that is of crucial value to the intercalated discs are the gap junctions. Gap junctions are proteinaceous tunnels that allow for the sharing of cytosol between two adjacent cardiac myocytes. This connection of the cytoplasm allows for all of the connected cardiac myocytes to function as one large syncytium. So all of these cells, by virtue of the fact that they are connected, can exquisitely well coordinate their activities. And as action potentials move down the line from one cell to the next, ions can freely flow from one cell to the next. Now, all cardiac muscle tissue is autorhythmic, but some collections of cardiac muscle tissue are more autorhythmic than others, or I should say, they have a higher intrinsic rate of depolarization. So the SA node at the superior aspect of the crista terminalis is one such area that has a very high rate of depolarization that serves as the pacemaker region for the heart. Now that leads us to the assessment question for this video, and that is, what feature of cardiac muscle tissue allows for coordinated depolarization? Is it that cardiac muscle tissue is autorhythmic, that there are desmosomes, gap junctions, large mitochondria, or that the cells are uninucleate? Well, the correct answer here are the gap junctions. The gap junctions are what allow for the cardiac myocytes to function as one large functional syncytium. The other aspects here are all true of cardiac muscle tissue, but they do not allow for necessarily coordinated depolarization. Thank you very much for your time.